of all, I would just like to thank Councilman Valladares and all the other council members on the committee for this opportunity to testify in front of you during this important hearing. My name is Quentin Walcott from Connect. I'm the director of many programs, most importantly, the Training Institute Community Empowerment Program and Men's Initiatives. Connect is dedicated to preventing interpersonal violence and promoting gender justice by building partnerships with individuals and communities. We strive to change the beliefs, behaviors, and institutions that perpetuate violence. Through legal empowerment, grassroots mobilization, transformative education, we seek to create safe families and peaceful communities. The issue, street harassment, is a rite of passage for men and boys who derive some benefits, some definite benefits from it. The young girls and women who primarily bear the brunt of it are forever changed by the experience. Street harassment is a phenomenon that's not exclusive to women and girls in New York City. In fact, it's a widespread and widely accepted behavior that compromises the safety and freedom of women and girls all over the world. Its roots are embedded in sexism, patriarchy, and misogyny. Sexual harassment is a tool that we as boys and men fall back on to publicly demonstrate our deeply embedded attitudes towards women and girls and to express how masculine we are to other men. Being born male comes with unearned privileges, entitlements, and expectations that allow us to negotiate the world in ways that young girls and women can never experience. We are socialized to view women as objects and property, and this thinking is supported inside our homes, institutions, and systems that we navigate on a daily basis. For some men, sexual harassment is a demonstration of men's attitudes and belief systems that falsely raise our collective esteem, value, and worth. Of course, this is at the cost of women and girls. I say our because those of us who don't directly engage in street harassment behavior still benefit by it when we don't hold other men accountable when it happens. This behavior benefits us as men since young girls and women emerge from the experience of being harassed with damaged self-esteem and self-value. They're deprived of basic human rights and autonomy that we are afforded to as men. Sexual harassment is a gendered bullying that also has to do with one's culture, ethnicity, race, class, sexuality, sexual orientation, and geographic location. Sexual harassment is not just verbal, it can be physical and sexual touching, isolation, stalking, which can lead to rape and death. Solutions. At Connect, we've been gratefully funded by the City Council to do domestic violence and gender violence prevention work in New York City. With that, we afforded a vantage point about violence that is wide and interconnected. We view many forms of violence that are viewed as private to have a very public nature. And intimate violence, often viewed as a woman's issue, to be a men's issue. Street harassment is a form of male violence against women. It's an issue that men must take responsibility for, moving from perpetrators and solid bystanders to allies and activists in the work to end male violence against women. Men play a pivotal role in eliminating family and gender violence, particularly when men commit over 90% of the reported cases of violence. A vital element of Connect's work is holding men accountable for the abuse they inflict upon their victims. Connect has built a solid foundation of successful men's programs designed to transform men's attitudes towards women, children, and other men. Connect's work with men serves as a dual purpose. Firstly, its strategy to keep women and children safe by doing prevention and intervention work with abusive men, bystanders, and male youth. Secondly, Connect is helping men recognize and transform the attitudes and belief systems that manifest in abusive behavior. Our goal is to develop a team of men who ally with women, reach out to other men and children in their respective communities, and develop responses to male and gender violence. Connect provides training, capacity building, and technical assistance to organizations, institutions, unions, human service organizations, from child welfare to Head Start to male and father involvement programs, veteran and reentry programs, and most importantly, youth. One program in particular that successfully addresses this goal is our Young Men's Project. The Manhood Development Project is designed specifically for young men in high schools and middle schools, for young men to critically examine cultural and historical belief systems and gender socializations that lead to family, domestic, teen dating, gang, and gender violence. Through this program, we look at abuse with a race, class, and gender analysis. Students explore how young men who are disenfranchised in society maintain power, male privilege, and entitlement within their intimate and communal relationships. These root causes that lead to teen dating violence and other forms of youth and community violence are investigated. The project provides a space for these young men to have age-specific conversations about manhood, male socialization, male accountability, gender equality, healthy and unhealthy dating relationships, sibling and peer relationships. We are grateful for the council for supporting this and other unique intensive programs that contribute to changing the culture of male violence and sexism in the new generation of New York City youth. Thank you.